My name is Pearl Lane. I live in Edinburgh. I'm originally from Limerick, southwest coast of Ireland. When I initially came here in 1975, I kind of came as a cadet nurse before I started my training. I was really only meant to stay for the 3 years to get my registration and then go back to Ireland to work. But I didn't. I had identified for quite a long time as a lesbian woman. And I knew there were plenty of organizations, although not as many as what there are now, but there was certainly a focus on people feeling more comfortable. And I certainly felt more a part of life in Scotland. And I guess as a result of that, I ended up continuing with my career and staying here. And I'm quite happy that I've made that choice, mainly because I think actually Scotland now kind of really holds the flag in terms of embracing people from different ethnic minority backgrounds, as well as, you know, just a diversity really of identity and of, you know, experience. In the early 1980s, I had chosen to do my psychiatric nurse training. And at that stage, all my textbooks referred to anybody who didn't identify as heterosexual was regarded as a sexual deviant. So I would signpost people to organizations that I knew of, but I wasn't able to be out at work because that wasn't okay to do that. And I was aware of that. So of course, I think in terms of one's identity, you know, you lose something in that mix because you're not able to, I didn't feel I was able to embrace my sexuality or even, I suppose in a way, enable myself to understand other people who would be in a similar position. And I think it makes a huge difference now in my present career and has been for quite a number of years to be out at work, to feel confident about being out at work. I work with people with disabilities, people with disabilities across the board, really. Some people with disabilities have difficulty expressing their sexuality. My role model training from Stonewall has really enabled me to help them to embrace their sexuality and to explore it in ways that, you know, I can signpost them on to agencies, etc., that can offer them support. I would definitely say my positive examples of being a lesbian in Scotland outweigh the negative ones. And it's kind of wonderful to be able to say that, you know, things have changed, and I have noticed in 30 years things have changed for the better. And I'm just hoping that they will continue to improve and that we'll have an even better Scotland as a result.